Hey everybody, that was me using the Chili Tools Profile Paint Scraper. I had actually never used a profile scraper before. I've always wanted to. I've seen window and door restoration specialists using them to carve out paint around the muntins and panels on doors and windows. That's not easy to do without a tool like this. Doors and windows have those profiled inner edges. They add contour and detail to the surfaces of the door. They just make it look more appealing. Then you paint it, and if you ever want to resurface it, you've got to have some way to scrape out the paint from those really intricate little details. It was fun to use, but they're not easy to use. You have to take a lot of different angles. You typically cut with the bevel up, and you have to do this hard scraping motion that I've heard the restoration specialists refer to as scotching. Also, you saw me using the heat gun, which you have to do to get the paint to be more malleable. It's especially important in really old houses like the one I was working on, where there's something like 6 to 7 layers of paint built up over time. Then there was a layer of varnish underneath and probably a primer on top of that. I was just doing a tiny little sample here, and even that was pretty labor intensive. Takes a lot of skill and basically knife work to use one of these things, but I got the feeling that if I got to do it again, I could probably speed it up, do it a lot faster next time, and I could probably switch through my bits or the cutter heads a lot faster to get into all those various little details and nooks. Restoration specialists who are normally tackling this work have a lot of different ways of doing this. Like for instance, they will typically sand down the flats. That's like the flat rails, the flat stiles. So any flat surface on the door or window, they'll be hitting with a power sander or an orbital sander first. Then they're typically using profile scrapers just to carve out the actual trim details and the trim profiles on the inner edges. Some things to note for safety's sake: heat guns are very dangerous. I've said multiple videos before this point, if you're gonna use heat guns, please be careful. They can burn your house down. The one I had gets up to like 1,000 degrees. The nozzle gets very hot. You can burn yourself with the nozzle. You can set fire to the things you're working on if you leave concentrated heat on them for too long, or if you even just set the tool aside somewhere. Be careful with heat guns. Also, anytime you're scraping old paint surfaces, anything before about 1975 or 76, there's a very good chance you have lead-based paint in there. You need to take the appropriate precautions when you think you're working with lead-based paint. Follow EPA guidelines. You'll probably have to bring in a restoration specialist to advise you, or you need to get them to do the work. That's important. They take that very seriously. Sometimes you have to send pieces of your woodworking off for testing to see if there is lead in it. I was actually wearing a respirator. You should definitely wear a respirator if you're scraping or sanding, because if you release those particles, you can breathe them in. Always be very, very careful with lead-based paint. Follow all guidelines and procedures set out by the EPA. That said, I'm not a pro at this, but I do want to thank Chili Tools for sending this thing out to me, because like I said, I always wanted to try it. Not as easy as it looks, but I got a little more practice with it now, even in that little area that I was working on. I would like to tackle a whole window at some point, and like most restoration specialists, I would probably remove it, take it to a shop where I can control more of the variables involved and work safer. What do you think? Have you ever used a profile scraper before? Do you have experience doing this? I know really high level specialists will actually cut their own bits to match trim profiles in windows and around muntins. If you do that, please let me hear about it down in the comments. I'm very curious about it. I'm gonna link this paint scraper down in the description below, as well as replacement blades, because Chili does make and supply replacement blades as well. Just a quick video on an interesting topic this week. As always, thanks for watching. Be sure to check back in for more videos coming up soon. And please consider subscribing and hitting that little bell button to turn on notifications. That way you'll know the moment we post something. I'm Ethan James with TheHansCarpenter.com. I'll see you next time.